Tre, I'm here with a new video, and today I'm doing something that I think I never done before. I love to watch these videos myself, but I don't know why I don't do them. And it's like a little mini review or like a little catch-up review. What should we call it? I don't know. But I usually only like review eyeshadow palettes, but I use other makeup than eyeshadow palettes, and I don't talk about them if they don't end up in my favorite videos. So I was like, okay, I have some base products that I've tried the last couple of months that I can share with you what I feel. So this is a little roundup review. I don't know, maybe this is going to be a short video, maybe I will babble crazy amount of lot, I don't know. But these are mostly base products, some blushes and a mascara, so I think we just hop into this. We can start with a primer, and this is... I don't know if this is a primer, if I'm gonna be honest. But it's the Milk Makeup Luminous Blur Stick. This is the blur stick, but it's a luminous one. And I used this in my Shop My Stash for this month. If you didn't know, I am... in February. I have no idea when this is coming up. I have used this before this month. Not a lot, but I've used it and I like it. I don't know if it does anything like to help my foundation to stay on better, but I like how it looks on the skin and I like how it looks underneath my foundation. I use it with mostly my serum foundation from The Ordinary, and I think it peeks through a little bit, and I like it. The only thing I don't like, I don't know how to like apply it. I take this and just go over my face and then take my fingers to like spread it out. I don't really like it, but I've tried with a brush and with a sponge, and I think the fingers are the best of the worst, if we say it like that. I think it's okay. I don't think I'm going to buy this again if I like ever use this up. I think it's good, but it's nothing like revolutionary to my base makeup. But yes, I wanted to try Milk really much because it finally came to Sweden last year. So yeah, it is good. It's nothing like blows my mind. I like it. I don't think I will buy it again, but I will keep on using this. And then we can take the other thing from Milk as well. I bought the concealer, the Flex Concealer. I am, maybe not anymore, but I was on the hunt for a really good concealer because the concealer I love with my whole heart is no longer available. And Millie from Bad to the Brow said that I maybe would like this, and I like it. Oh no, maybe not. I think it's okay. It is not like a thick concealer, it's not like a heavy concealer, but I think it is really dry. I want my concealers to be a little bit more liquidy. This is pretty dry, and I don't really like this. I have never been a tube kind of girl. I don't like things that comes in a tube like this. No. And it doesn't feel like it's that much in it, but I think it's like a normal concealer, but I don't think it's worth the money. It's okay, but I think like it's too dry for me, and I like my concealers more liquidy. I use this sometimes, not right now. It is okay, but it's not like... I wouldn't recommend it if you want... if you want a concealer. If you want a concealer that is maybe pretty lightweight, but it covers good, and you don't mind like a little bit drier concealer, I think you will like this, but it's not my favorite. It is okay. It was pretty pricey for me because I usually don't buy these pricey concealers, but I think it's good, but nothing like it, not blows my mind. And the last, like, typical base thing. I was so looking forward to this, and I saw a lot of reviews, and people were so happy about this. No. And it's the Pretty Fresh Hyaluronic Acid Tinted Moisturizer. I bought this because I want a pretty light coverage in my foundation, and I want something that is not drying on my face, and this seemed to be perfect. The problem I have with this, the shade is actually good for once, ColourPop are good at doing light shades, but it is so, it never dries down on me. And I don't mind things that don't dry down, like the serum foundation from Ordinary don't dry down. Like, I'm a little bit like, you can feel it. I don't think I can lay on like a white pillow. But this foundation from The Ordinary doesn't move around. But this, if I like touched my face, like my fingers got stuck to my face. It's so freaking sticky. And then I was like, okay, I take some powder. And it ate like all my powder. It like, it never got normal. I had to put on so much powder. And I have a dry skin. So I don't know how people with like a oily skin can like this. I don't understand hype. And I'm a little bit angry that I don't, because this sounded like something that I would really, really like, but I just don't do it. And I don't know if I have any pale friends that this will suit, but I think I maybe will try to use it more, but I don't like it because it never, like, dries down that I can... It doesn't need to be completely dry, but it has to dry down so I feel, like, comfortable to wear it, but... This doesn't, and I can't put anything over it. Like, I have to set it before I put on, like, blush and highlight and stuff. And for do that, it needs so much powder, and, like, no. Because I want something that is not makes me dry. But this, no. No, no, no. I don't like it. No. Then we can do some stick things, and I have never really talked about this, I think. Maybe a little. It's the Nip and Fab Fix Sticks Definition in Coal Taupe. Looks like this. I have it on today. I have it in my shop, my stash. And the first time I used this, I didn't know, like, how to do it, so I didn't like it that much. Now I use it with this brush from Real Techniques that is a contour brush. This is such a good combo. I really like this one now. I think it suits my skin. It's easy to like work into the skin, and I really like it. The only thing I don't like, it's so like, the packaging is so plasticky, and like, I don't like the packaging, but the product is really, really good. And together with this brush, it is amazing. So if you want to try cream contour, try this. I don't think they have that many colors, unfortunately. Or do they? It was a long time ago since I bought this. I think it was the summer. And I think I have one of the lightest shades. Probably do. It's really good, and I'm glad that I started with something cheaper and that it's good. I think if I have bought something that wasn't good, I think this cream contour thing would not be my thing. But this one is really, really good. So try it if you want to try. Just do it. I can recommend it. Then I also want to talk about three blushes. I've talked about these before, but not like a proper review of them. And it's the Bear With Me blushes from NYX. I have used Detox Me today. This is in my shop, my stash for February. And I really, really like these. But it was the same with these as with the contour stick. I didn't know how to work with them. I usually use this stippling brush from Real Techniques. This is like not such a dense stippling brush, and this works so good. And I don't think you're supposed to do this, but I do like this. I don't think that these blushes work as good if you take them directly on your skin. These are better with a brush, in my opinion. But I think that these are really easy to work with, and I can't like feel them on my skin, so that's why I like them. And even though maybe like this Detox Me looks a little bit scary in color, I don't know, it is really good, and I really enjoy this one. And these were the first stick blushes I tried, so I can recommend them if you want to try stick blushes. And the last stick thing is from Nabla. This is, I don't know if it's just stick highlighter. This is in Surreal. I have this on today. It is amazing. I really like it. I think the first time I used it, I wasn't like blown away. I think it was because I didn't know how to use it. This one works as good as like just taking it on, and then I take it out with a stippling brush. This is a smaller and denser stippling brush than the other one. It works like that, or it works like this as well if you take it with the brush. But this one I really like to put on and then take it out with a stippling brush, because I don't feel that this is like rubbing away the foundation. So this one I can really recommend. I don't know if they have, how many colors they have, and I hope this is still available. I have no idea, actually. Maybe I should have looked it up before I recommend this. But this one I really like. And then the last thing I wanted to talk about is the ColourPop BFF Volumizing Mascara. I don't like this. I do not. I have it on today, and I don't know if it still shows, but yeah, it like crumbles on me. I have like a lot of black spots right here. Maybe can brush them away. Yeah, I can, but like no mascara has ever crumbled on me like this. It didn't do it in the beginning, but now I have used it maybe 3 months or something. Maybe more, maybe I should just change it. But I didn't like it at the beginning either. I think it just like make my lashes black. They don't make them longer. They make them a little bit fuller, but I think it is a hard brush to work with. It is a pretty big brush. And I love like the Too Faced better than Sex. But this one I don't like it, and it's no, I don't think it's good. I got this as a gift. I think when there was Pretty New, I got this as a gift. And it feels like when I paint it on, I have to do it like 5 times to really have them black. And I have like blonde eyelashes, so it shouldn't be that hard for me to have color on my lashes. But this one, I have to work really, really long with it, and I just don't like it. And it crumbles on me. It has always crumbled a little bit, but now the older it gets, it gets worse. So I'm not going to buy this again. Happy for you if you like this and think this is good, but I don't. I wouldn't recommend this, but yeah, for free mascara it is okay, but I don't like it. It like destroy my makeup. It doesn't look good when with black mascara spots on my face. And yeah, that was all of my little mini reviews. I hope you like this. I don't know if I will keep continuing doing these, because I don't change my base product that often and like buy new base products that often. But I think I wanted just to talk about base products, because as I said, I like never do, because I mostly do eyeshadows. So yeah, I really hope you like this video, and if you like any of these products, it is okay. We don't have to like the same things, and maybe you hate something that I love, that is also okay. But yeah, I really hope you like this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye! Bye.